Over the past 10 years, SpaceX has conquered the spaceflight industry. In 2013, the company had just 3 launches. In 2023, it has 90 so far, and may reach 100 before the end of the year. This year, SpaceX makes up nearly half of all global launches, and 80% of payload mass launched into space. A single player, outperforming every other nation and company combined. SpaceX's workhorse, the Falcon 9, is arguably the most reliable rocket ever built, with well over 200 consecutive successful launches. But what's the story behind SpaceX's groundbreaking rise? Today we explore how SpaceX and its founder Elon Musk came to dominate the world of spaceflight. SpaceX's journey began in 2001, when Elon Musk wanted to reignite public interest in space exploration and announced Mars Oasis, a project to grow plants on Mars. He then reached out to Russian contacts to purchase refurbished Dnieper rockets. But after a Russian engineer spat on his shoes, Musk decided on the flight back home that he would start his own company to compete with them, and founded SpaceX in 2002. This event might have changed the world and sealed the fate of Russia's space industry, as SpaceX today launches 8 times as many rockets annually as Russia does. SpaceX's first rocket was the Falcon 1, a small lift vehicle which had its first launch attempt in March 2006. This first launch failed, as did the next 2 attempts in March 2007 and August 2008. These failures, the global economic crisis of that year, and the $90 million development costs of the Falcon 1 put SpaceX and Musk's other company, Tesla, in financial limbo. Musk said, "I could either pick SpaceX or Tesla or split the money I had left between them. That was a tough decision. If I split the money, maybe both of them would die. If I gave the money to just one company, the probability of it surviving was greater, but then it would mean certain death for the other company." But Falcon 1's fourth launch in September 2008 was a success, and Musk ended up splitting the money between both companies. In December 2008, NASA awarded a $1.6 billion commercial resupply contract to SpaceX, saving the company from financial ruin. Musk later said, "That was the last money we had for Falcon 1. That fourth launch worked. Or it would have been, that would have been it for SpaceX." SpaceX's next rocket, and the one that changed the world, was the Falcon 9, named after the Millennium Falcon from Star Wars. Its first launch on June 4th, 2010, marked the beginning of a new era in space travel. There have been many different variants over the years, including version 1.0, 1.1, Full Thrust Block 3, and Full Thrust Block 4. Only the latest variant, Full Thrust Block 5, remains active today. With a max payload to low Earth orbit of almost 23 metric tons, Falcon 9 makes up nearly half of all global launches in 2023, driven by its reliability and price. With a 99.3% success rate and 200 plus consecutive successful missions, Falcon 9 might be the most reliable rocket ever built. While other rockets like the Atlas V and Delta IV Heavy have 0 failures compared to 1 full failure for the Falcon 9, their launch volume has also been much lower. One key factor in SpaceX's dominance is price competitiveness, driven by the company's focus on reusability. In December 2015, SpaceX made history by landing the first stage of a Falcon 9 after launch, allowing it to be reused for future missions. The reuse record for a Falcon 9 booster is 18 missions. This is 18 additional first stage rockets the company didn't need to build. As a result, SpaceX is one of the lowest cost players in the industry, with a launch price of about $2,700 per kilogram for the Falcon 9. Another key driver of SpaceX's low costs is its focus on vertical integration. By designing and manufacturing the majority of its components in-house, SpaceX maintains tighter control over its supply chain and production process. This approach not only reduces the need for external suppliers, but also allows for rapid iterations and improvements in technology. SpaceX's vertical integration enables it to quickly adapt and implement changes, significantly cutting down production times and costs. As a result, this strategy has given SpaceX a competitive edge in the industry. In February 2018, SpaceX launched the Falcon Heavy, a more powerful version of the Falcon 9, which features three boosters that can lift almost 64 metric tons to low Earth orbit. The rocket is even cheaper on a per kilogram basis than the Falcon 9, at about $1,500 per kilogram. The Falcon Heavy is also reusable, with the side boosters being recaptured on most of its missions. Until the launch of the SLS in November 2022, Falcon Heavy was the most powerful rocket in the world. In 2013, SpaceX was a tiny player in the spaceflight industry, with just 3 launches out of 81 that year. Russia was the leader in launch volume with 31 launches. Other companies like Europe's Ariane Space and the American United Launch Alliance were considered large players in the commercial space. That same year, Ariane Space director Richard Bowles said SpaceX was selling a dream, and that reusability is a dream. Also in 2014, as NASA was working with SpaceX to stop relying on Russian rockets for manned American spaceflight, Russian Deputy Prime Minister Dmitry Rogozin mocked both groups, telling the US to bring their astronauts to the ISS using a trampoline. In 2020, a SpaceX Falcon 9 successfully transported American astronauts to the ISS for the first time in 9 years without Russian rockets. Elon Musk responded, "The trampoline is working." Ariane Space as well is planning to introduce a reusable rocket in the future after realizing the need to bring down costs. Today, SpaceX stands as a titan and de facto monopolist in the launch industry, with Falcon 9 at its core. In 2024, SpaceX plans to launch 144 missions, which corresponds to a cadence of one launch every 2.5 days. This would beat the company's own record of up to 100 launches in 2023, which itself beats SpaceX's 2022 record of 61 launches. The only benchmark for SpaceX's performance is its past self. But while Falcon 9 is what led to the dominance of SpaceX today, its future position looks stronger than ever. With the development of Starship, SpaceX may bring launch costs down below $1,000 per kilogram. The rocket has already flown twice this year, with a second flight in November 2023 managing to reach space. With the potential to carry 250 metric tons to low Earth orbit, Starship could become the most powerful rocket in the world in the coming years. Starship's goal is to enable humans to return to the moon and eventually Mars. NASA has tapped Starship as a key part of its Artemis 3 mission, which aims to land humans on the lunar surface in 2025. Elon Musk, meanwhile, has always said his ultimate goal is to create a self-sustaining colony on Mars. Starship's reusability is essential to that vision. Just as SpaceX was founded in the aftermath of the Mars Oasis project, it continues to push towards that goal today. While SpaceX is making progress on Starship, other companies are still working to build competitors to the Falcon 9. Ariane Space's reusable spacecraft, the Ariane Next, is not expected to be released until 2030, while Ariane 6 is also running behind schedule. ULA's Falcon is yet to launch, is not reusable, and costs more than the Falcon 9. Blue Origin's New Glenn has also been delayed and will not launch before 2024. As a result, SpaceX stands alone in the commercial space industry, and no clear competitor is on the horizon. However, the company's accomplishments have also sparked a new wave of interest in space, with more to look forward to in the future. Even as SpaceX is at the forefront of innovation today, dozens of companies and agencies are tirelessly working to continue improving our access to space. The same unpredictable disruption that SpaceX brought to the industry could be replicated in the future. But no matter what happens, the company has played a crucial role in humanity taking another step towards the stars. What part of SpaceX's journey to dominance are you most impressed by? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Drop a like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. I'll see everyone next time.